some years, we have been seeing that the government policy of towards higher education has been such that the grant that we're getting to the for the universities has been gradually reduced. And this has happened very drastically at the time of the current government also. But the root cause of this, in my mind, is that at one point of time in 2005, the government of India signed the GATS treaty for higher education, in which there is a clause which says that to create favorable trade conditions for all the players from different countries, you have to reduce or completely remove the subsidy given to Indian universities. As a result of which, continuously policies are being made in such a manner as to reduce funding to the universities. This particular government has gone ahead at a very great speed and viciously crushed all dissent.
The MHRD is imposing a tripartite MOU on all central universities. This memorandum of understanding, it basically allows the government to bypass the UGC, which is an autonomous grant funding agency, and it allows to take over the funding functions directly under its own sort of executive authority. And it also makes funding conditional, funding for public funded universities like DU, conditional upon certain performance evaluation targets that it will set for universities. Now these targets are really absurd because they are quantified targets meant to evaluate things that are basically qualitative.
The policy assault at every level has started. Funds are not being released, the pensions are not being released, the allowances are not being released, research grant has not come up, the travel grant for, you know, when you go for seminars, it has not been given. And this is happening in central universities, which are in Delhi. So I hope you can understand what is the state of the other universities.
जो सरकार है, वो DU के 6 कॉलेजों को लगातार autonomous करने की कोशिश कर रही है. ऑटोनॉमस करने का मतलब ये कि सरकार उनसे ये कह रही है कि आप अपने हिसाब से सिलेबस बना सकते हैं, परीक्षाएं ले सकते हैं, नई ब्रांचेस खोल सकते हैं और सब कुछ कर सकते हैं, बस हम आपको पैसा नहीं देंगे. इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका मतलब ये है कि जो एक तरीके से पब्लिक फंडेड यूनिवर्सिटीज़ थी DU, जहाँ पर सरकार कुछ पैसा देती थी, अब उसको भी इस ऑटोनॉमस के जरिए प्राइवेट करने की दिशा में धकेला जा रहा है.
दे आर आस्किंग द यूनिवर्सिटीज़ टू take research grants from corporate sources through an extramural funding program. They are asking us to take loans for infrastructure from HEFA, which basically raises funds from the capital markets and asks universities like ours to pledge our assets, our land, our building, all our intellectual resources as securities against the loans that we will be forced to take. Now this means that the students who are going to come to a place like Delhi University are going to come to mortgaged buildings, they are going to study in mortgaged libraries, all of which are publicly owned. This is a sinister plan to eventually hand over publicly owned resources to private sector.
They have one after the other brought certain regulations, cutting down the number of posts in universities, reducing funding through privatization in one form or the other. The latest is to force all central universities to sign a memorandum of understanding which says that we will take loans rather than grants. And to pay back those loans, we will show that we have the capacity to pay back the loans by immediately raising students' fees. Now, if we have to pay for infrastructure, for new posts and so on, then the students' fees will be going into lakhs, like it is in private universities. So the immediate impact will be A, on the kind of students coming in. Bulk of Indian, 99%, will not be able to afford higher education. They have to take steep loans, which they may not be able to repay because they don't have any jobs coming up either. The second thing that was happening is that the content of education will change, because those subjects which are not fetching high fees, which are not getting many takers who are willing to pay high fees, will slowly die down. So the humanities and the social sciences and language courses will suffer very badly.
They are insisting that the university should commit to incremental hikes in student fees, which is, you know, it has happened earlier. We have forced them to push their agenda back, but they are bringing it in a new kind of way and trying to ensure that higher education becomes out of reach for poorer sections, especially for women.
ये मोदी का विकास है, ये कभी विकास होकर के नहीं रहेगा। आपको हर बार लगेगा कि सब कुछ हो गया है, सब कुछ हरियाली दिखाई दे रहा है, लेकिन आपको पता चलेगा कि आप रेगिस्तान के बीच में हैं। तो जब हैं तो लड़ाई लड़ने के लिए आपको हमको तैयार रहना पड़ेगा।
You know, at times in pay commission and other related issues, Duta takes a lead because it's in Delhi, and it is you could say that since we are in Delhi, there is a locational advantage, and since media may even cover us, which may not be possible in other states. But a fight against privatization and commercialization of higher education cannot be only on the shoulders of the DUTA.
The overall implication of the tripartite MOU is privatization and commercialization. It is against the interests of the larger majority of people who want access to higher education, who want a modicum of equity to exist in the higher education system.
हमारा जो एक संविधान है जिसके तहत हमारी ये शिक्षा नीति बनी थी और पब्लिक फंडेड इंस्टीट्यूशंस बने थे, उसकी धज्जियां उड़ाई जा रही है। जो अफर्मेटिव एक्शन हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में लिखा है, आरक्षण नीति जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में लिखी है, उसको पूरी तरह से इस सरकार ने खत्म कर दिया है।